I'm here in the De La Salle National Boys School in Ballyfermot. The school was opened in 1952, and sadly it's going to close on the 28th of June 2019. The De La Salle was founded in 1685 by John Baptist De La Salle. He was born in Reims in France, and he spent most of his life teaching children. He died in April 1719 in Normandy at the age of 68. He was canonized by Pope Leo in 1900. The De La Salle are celebrating their tricentenary year, as this marks the 300th anniversary of John Baptist De La Salle's death. It's over 50 years since I attended school here. My last class was in 1960. And this is the classroom where I spent the last year, room number 29. Some of my teachers were Mr. Mullery, Brother James, and Mr. Murphy. The Christian Brothers have been educating the boys in Ballyfermot for the last 67 years, and there's been a lot of changes. In 1960, there were 1,600 children enrolled in the school. However, today, there are only 52. So before we close the gates for the last time, let's take a last look around the school. On the 1st of May 2019, Ballyfermot Heritage organised a trip down memory lane for past pupils and teachers to share their memories. But first, let's take a step back in time to 1948, where it all began. Dublin city tenements in the 1940s had the worst housing conditions in Europe. Our story starts in 1948, as hundreds of families from the inner city moved into their new homes in Ballyfermot. The first houses were built on Sarchfield Road. Then they moved on to Landon Road, and on to Lally Road and the lower part of Ballyfermot. The development of Ballyfermot had just started, and as this was going to be one of the biggest housing estates in Ireland, the education of the children was going to be very important. As there was no schools, some of the children had to go to the model schools in Inchicore. Others went to Whitefriar Street School, which was in town. They had to get a special bus every morning from Ballyfermot. The Archbishop of Dublin, Reverend John Charles McQuaid, asked the De La Salle Order of Christian Brothers to start up a school in Ballyfermot. And at that time, it was suggested that they build a school in the grounds of the Royal Hospital in Kilmainham. However, eventually, they bought a site from the corporation on Ballyfermot Road for £3,711. This was a few acres which stretched from Ballyfermot Road right back to St. Lawrence's Road in Chapelizard. In 1949, they engaged architect Simon Aloysius Leonard of W.H. Bourne and Sons to draw up plans for the new school. G&T Crampton Builders, who were already building houses on Sarchfield Road, got the contract to build a new school. And on the 6th of June 1950, at a special ceremony, they laid the foundation stone for the monastery. The stone was laid by the Archbishop of Dublin, Reverend John Charles McQuaid, and he was presented with this silver trowel by the builders. The school was built in three sections. The first to be built was Skull Isacon, and it opened on the 7th of January 1952. And on that day, 380 children were enrolled in the school. The first boy to be enrolled was Brendan MacDade from Ballyfermot Road. The official opening ceremony was held on the 26th of October 1953 by the then Minister for Education, Sean Moylan, TD. And this is the silver key which was presented to Sean Moylan and Brother Thomas at the opening ceremony. Brother Thomas was the first principal of the De La Salle. And later that year, in September, School Muir and School Joseph were opened. The brothers allowed the Dominican sisters to have five classrooms in the top of School Eastacombe to teach juniors and girls while their convent was being built. And in 1954, there were 23 brothers, including brothers Amy, Ramal, David, Philpart, Joseph and James. Brother Andrew managed a small farm at the back of the monastery. The lay teachers were Messrs. Keegan, Murphy, O'Gallagher, Mulry and O'Flaherty. And the school catered for boys from second class up to sixth class. In the 1950s and 60s, the school had 1,600 children enrolled. There were 50 pupils per class, which meant they were using 32 classrooms. And at that time, it was one of the biggest schools in Europe. On May the 31st, 1952, 200 pupils were taken to St. Michael's Church in Inchicore, where they received their first Holy Communion. On the 5th of June 1952, the first Corpus Christi procession was held. The brothers and all the pupils from the school took part. It began at the hut on O'Hogan Road, and it went up Deasy's Road, down Cremona Road, back up Landon Road, along to Kylemore Road and down Ballyfermot Road, ending at the Brothers' Monastery. An altar had been erected on the lawns in front of the monastery and benediction was held there. The congregation knelt on the roads and in the park. Here's a short clip from the Rocky Road to Dublin, which was filmed in Ballyfermot, of the children going to school.
Because of Adam's sin, we are born without sanctifying grace. Our intellect is dark and our will is weak and our passions and minds feeble, and we are subject to suffering and death.
We're going away from the holy ground and the girls that we love through. We will sail the salt sea over and then return for shore to see again the girls we love and the holy ground once more.
I'm a girl, you are a girl, I do adore, and still I live in my hopes to see the holy ground once more.
I see it coming soon, and the sky it is so cloudy, you can scarcely see the moon. And the moon, you said, she was tossing about, the rig and was on shore, and still I live in hope to see the holy ground once more.
I'm a girl, you are a girl, I do adore, and still I live the holy ground once more. Fine girl, you are.
Now the storm is over, and we are safe on shore.
In September 1954, the Dominican sisters vacated the top story of Skull Isacon, as their schools were now complete. The brothers were very involved and had a big influence in the community of Ballyfermot. They held community events such as films each week and concerts in St. Benilde's Hall. St. Benilde's Hall was the first cinema in Ballyfermot, and they had a weekly matinee for the boys every Wednesday. It was called the Sixpenny Rush, as it was 6 old pence admission. Before the film, they would show an episode of The Lone Ranger and Tonto, or Roy Rogers, and a favourite of the boys was Old Mother Riley. And these always ended with a cliffhanger, so you couldn't wait for the following Wednesday to see what happened. The projectionist was Terry O'Neill from Coilmore Road. Terry was a well-known photographer in Ballyfermot, and the story he used to tell back in the 1960s was when they had a full week of concerts in the hall. One of the nights, three lads from Inchicore appeared, calling themselves the Harmonicords, and they went on to become world famous when they later changed their name to the Bachelors. They also ran bingo in a classroom in Skull Joseph in the 1950s. In those days, it was called Pongo. The first Ballyfermot Credit Union was started in a room at the back of St. Benilde's Hall, and it is now one of the biggest in Ireland. The first Mount LaSalle Parents Committee, where Brother Augustine, Brother Sebastian, Gay Kyo, Mr. and Mrs. Jago, Mr. and Mrs. Kennedy, and they organized a lot of the fundraising events in the early years. And of course, the school sports day. Mr. O'Neill was the drill teacher, and he would put the boys through their display for weeks before the sports day. The school sports day was first held in Richmond Park. It later moved to the Speedway Stadium in Chapelizod, and they finished up having it on the sports field in the De La Salle. Sport was a big part of school life. Here are some of the trophies which took pride of place in the school. Thanks to Brother Olton and Siobhan Kennedy, these trophies and memorabilia have been preserved by the Ballyfermot Heritage Group. The many hurling and Gaelic football teams have won almost every trophy there was to be won. Music was also a big part of school life, and there were many bands in the school. The first band was started by Brother Victor. Brother Victor started the now famous De La Salle Boys Band around 1954. He started off with a few pupils learning the accordion and the tin whistle, but as news got around, more and more boys wanted to join, and as the band got bigger, he added a lot more instruments. Brother Victor's style was a lot of marches, jigs and reels, and a few Strauss waltzes, and they recorded 3 records, thanks to Aidan MacLeod for a recording of these records. In 1959, the band went on tour of England and Scotland, where they also recorded, and they were under the direction of Brother Bonaventure. In the early 60s, Brother Cyprian took over, and Brother Cyprian had a different style of music. It was a more popular, more music of the day. In 1964, the band toured America under the Tara Boys Band with a company called Ireland on Parade, which included Eamon Andrews, Brett O'Donovan, Patrick O'Hagan, Mary Sheridan, and the Irish Garda Band. They toured around 18 states, including New York, Montreal, Boston, Toronto, Detroit, Baltimore, Ohio, and many more. And they finished up in Washington, playing in the White House for President and Mrs. Johnson. One of two bands Brother James taught was the flute and harmonica, and the other was the button accordion Cayley Band. The School Around the Corner was a very popular radio show in the 1960s. It was presented by Paddy Crosby, who was a school teacher in Brunswick Street School. He travelled around schools all over Ireland and interviewed school children. And he came to the National Boys School in Ballyfermot. One of the boys he interviewed was 11-year-old Thomas Walsh, and we're lucky enough to have a short recording of this.
Mary Eve, Paddy Crosby here. I have great pleasure in bringing you this week to one of the largest building schemes in Ireland, or rather, to the school which caters for this building scheme. The name of the school is Ballyfermot Boys National School, conducted by the De La Salle brothers. Oh, you're dressed and all with your accordion. Now, will you be able to move with that thing?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now, will you speak up?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Now, move in. But don't hit the microphone with that big accordion. You won't?
No, sir.
Have you a box car to that?
Yes, sir.
And you wheel it along?
Yes, sir.
Who taught that? Who thought of that idea?
Brother Victor told us to make a box car that it'd be easier for us to push.
Well, that's a very heavy instrument, isn't it? What's your name?
Thomas Walsh.
What age are you?
11.
And what class?
5th standard.
And do you like school? No, so you don't?
Sometimes.
Sometimes. Did you ever Mitch?
No, sir.
You sure?
Yes, sir.
Do you smoke?
When I was a little boy.
Don't call me your brother. I'm not a brother. Don't say brother to me. What will you say to me?
Sir.
Sir, well, go ahead.
Sir, when I was a little boy, two big boys brought me down the street and they gave me a pull of a cigarette. And me fired off knew. And when I went home that evening, me mammy said, "Where were you?" Says, "I down the street playing with Levo." And so she went, "Are you sure of that?" And says I, "Certain of it." And so she, "Come here."
Wait a minute, did she know you were smoking?
Yes, sir.
Somebody told?
Yes, sir.
All right. Did you get a walloping?
I got a flogging.
I got a flogging. Did you ever go on holidays anywhere?
Down to Belfast last year.
How long did you spend there?
3 days.
Well, another one. Now, if you live in Ballyfermot, do you ever go into the city itself?
Yes, sir.
Well, what brings you in there? Now, don't say a bus.
I go in to get me treadmill oiled.
You go in to get your clarinet oiled?
Yes, sir.
Do you play the clarinet too?
Yes, sir.
And the accordion?
Yes, sir.
What are you going to be when you grow up? I bet a musician.
A musician.
Are you?
Yes, sir.
In McNamara's band. Well, you can play that and you can play the clarinet. Can you play anything else?
A fragile.
What?
A fragile.
All right, that's three.
Yes, sir.
Any brother at home able to play anything?
A fragile and the accordion.
Your brother?
And another brother's able to play the drums.
Do you ever just strike up together?
Yes, sir.
And until somebody tells you to stop?
Until my dad says he's a penny sound.
And so we pull the brakes and ease up on our little romp. We say farewell to Ballyfermot Boys National School Dublin and extend greetings to all past pupils. Next week, Lacoon of Day, we shall be visiting another school when we hope to introduce some other pupils of the present to the pupils of the past. Back to the school around the corner.
Thomas as many of the Ballyfermot boys' bands. Was very lucky to have a great career in music. He is a multi-instrumentalist. He plays the accordion, saxophone and clarinet. And he was the second boy to join Brother Victor's band. In the early 60s, he joined one of Ballyfermot's top show bands, the Young Shadows. Thomas and his band Turlough have travelled extensively. He has composed many tunes, and his CDs are very popular all over Europe. His most famous tune, Inishere, which we used for the introduction of this film, has been recorded by groups and bands all over the world. In 1968, Brother Coleman and some of his class took part in the St. Patrick's Day Parade as the Lion's Tea Minstrel.
Buy Lion's Tea, drink Lion's Tea, love Lion's Tea. Lion's the quality tea, freshly packed and full flavored. Lion's the quality tea.
In the 1980s, vocations in the teaching order fell dramatically. And as a result, Elizabeth Smith was employed as school secretary, the first woman to be employed by the De La Salle School. And in 1982, three more lay teachers were employed. They were Siobhan Cross, Naomi Plant, and Mary O'Shaughnessy, R.I.P. And in 2003, Mrs. Plant became school principal. Brother Eugene, who was the last teaching brother, retired in 2012. Apart from teaching, he had a keen interest in Gaelic football, and he coached many of the children's teams. He also had a love of music. He taught the guitar and tin whistle. And after retiring, he returned to the school a few times each week to teach music to the boys. In 2014, it was decided to amalgamate the schools in Ballyfermot. Unfortunately, all the protests fell on deaf ears, and the amalgamation went ahead. This meant that instead of the boys passing from the Dominican convent to the De La Salle, they would continue their education in the Dominican convent. And this was the start of the end for the decline of the De La Salle. On the 13th of October 2015, the national flag was presented to the school as part of the 1916 commemorations. In 2016, the school celebrated the centenary of the Easter Rising, and past pupil Joe Duffy was the master of ceremonies for the day. The theme was The Children of 1916, which was the title of Joe's best-selling book. Past pupil Declan O'Rourke returned to his old school and performed his own song, The Children of 1916. With the boys and Brother Eugene's band.
In the town of Easter Mons, a hundred years ago, the river's there, the river's there,
13th of July, 2018, we got word that the monastery was being vacated. Brother Olton invited us down to have a look around. Later that month, we had a last look around as the removal men moved in. And this was one of the most saddest sights to befall Ballyfermot.
Thank you.
The last nativity play by the boys in sixth class took place on the 19th of December 2018. The 1st of February 2019 was a big day in the De La Salle. Ballyfermot Heritage organised a trip down memory lane for past pupils and teachers, which had a great support.
a comment, let's say, from one of the brothers. But I just wanted to gather your attention for a moment to say you are all very, very welcome to De La Salle today. If you are a past pupil or connected to a past pupil, or you have a pupil in the school at the moment, this is a day for you to be a VIP and to say you are welcome to come back. The Memory Lane Walk or the Walkabout Day is an opportunity for us to celebrate the heritage and the connection with De La Salle Ballyfermot. Whether you were here for a year or 5 years or a very short time, whether it was last year, 10 years ago or 50 years ago, it's only a very short time. If you have a clear conscience about your time in De La Salle, maybe your memory isn't that very good, but you are welcome. And I saw a quote from some famous writer who said that pure terror is to waken up one morning and find out that your classmates or the boys you went to school with are running the country today. Anyway, what we're doing is we're gathering here in the hall an opportunity for you to meet those classmates and share stories with them. I know there's a teacher, Mr. O'Rourke, if you remember him, is here. And we'll stay here for a little while, and then there's tea and coffee in the staff room. The boys are in school still, so we kind of need, for child protection reasons, to leave them safe in the classrooms and not to be wandering around the corridor. But later on they will be gone, and there will be an opportunity to have a look on the corridor where there are pictures and memorabilia displayed. And then room 26, which some of you may have been in, is done up like an old classroom with the types of books and stuff that you would have had as a pupil in the class. And I looked at it this morning, so this is a nicer classroom than I ever had. But you're very welcome today. Please enjoy the visit. Can I say, the rules that were back in 1952 when we opened first still are valid. There is no smoking allowed in the school, so if you're tired from chatting, then you wait till you go outside the school grounds before you have that cigarette. You don't have to hide behind bike sheds anymore. But if you wouldn't mind, please, there is no smoking. And I know Ken wants to say a word. The boys will be playing music as well for you. They are the current trustees of the De La Salle spirit, and hopefully they will follow you and carry that spirit with them wherever they go, like you do.
Yeah. It's not a day for long speeches, more for remembering. But it is people, a day like today can't help without help. And we had lots and lots of help from this man and all the staff here. We would like to thank for their help. I have to give a special mention to a few of the staff though, because I know they did all this stuff, all these Phillips and all, and that's a special mention to Linda Corcoran, Elizabeth Phillips, Liam O'Brien and Keith Walsh. We would have been talking about there's brother Eugene and the boys here, and they're going to play for you. Brother Eugene, he retired in 2012, but he's been back here every day since 2000. He never retired, really. He's back here teaching boys, and he's become a legend. And the reason I know that is, we were up doing a project with St. John's School there recently, and we mentioned Brother Eugene, and of course, you could see their faces lit up, and that's what they call him, Ballyfermot legend. So he's been knighted a Ballyfermot legend. And I want to... give a special mention to our heritage group, all the lads who backed this idea, which was great. And a special mention to Sean Brennan, Susan Plummer, John Deary and Tom Murphy, who helped to get this place ready. I'm delighted to see Mr. O'Rourke. I had Mr. O'Rourke in forecast, so if anyone had Mr. O'Rourke, he's over here to the right, and he'd love to have a chat with you. So I'm delighted to see him along. Thank you. Thank you.
much. Okay, bye-bye.
To Miss Plant, who is principal at the De La Salle and who will be well known down the years. For how many years is it?
I came here in 1982 and I was one of three female teachers who started as permanent teachers on the same day. So that's 37 years ago now.
And when did you become principal?
I became principal in 2003 with Mr. Deely.
It must be great for the older people, seeing the older people coming back now. For instance, I know even before your time we had to walk about here,
yes,
and it was great to hear their memories. It must be great to hear the children that you taught now that are such an age.
Yes,
you know?
It's lovely to see them wanting to come back and treasuring their memories of the school here. This morning we had a boy who left us a number of years ago and he wanted to come back and say hello to the teachers, those he remembers. And the walkabout day was lovely, particularly for teachers who are here now. Sometimes you only hear the bad news, but it was lovely to see people with fond memories walking around, and that was a very successful day. You don't necessarily hear about those who are successful. They just go off and do their own thing, and some of them have done fantastic work, and they have good memories of
the school. Right, yeah. It was lovely to meet Mr. O'Rourke as well, teacher. But it's always nice. And have you lined up yourself for?
I will be going to Holy Cross National School in Dundrum. Now, just as a mainstream teacher, it's not very far away from where I live, so it'll be very handy.
And have you got a lasting memory? Will you bring a lasting memory of the school with you then?
I think the warmth and friendship of not only the children and their families, because I worked with families for about 6 years, and the genuine spirit that is in the families here, and the friendship camaraderie of the teachers. I hold that with me.
Well, as I say, we wish you the best of luck for the future.
Thank you very much.
Talking to a man that really needs no introduction at all. He's well known around Ballyfermot for his community work, teaching the children the music, Brother Eugene. And thanks for taking time out of your day to talk to us.
Thanks for the invitation.
Oh, absolutely.
I came to Ballyfermot in 1985 and I was approached by parents to strengthen up the local GA, juvenile GA club in Ballyfermot at the time, and they asked me would I more or less come on board and if I could give direction and kind of led the whole project, that they would come on board. And we started off with an under 10 Gaelic team, and we became a member of the South East board in Dublin. We became a member of that, and then more or less the club mushroomed from that. Then we had under 10s, under 11s all the way up, and most of my energy, weekends particularly, was spent in that field during the GAA.
And then you say how many you taught, when you came to Ballyfermot, how many were you teaching then?
The class would have been 30 plus. Great energy and no trouble.
Yeah.
Spend most of my time out in the field, I was told.
Thank you. Well, thanks for all your work. And I know when we put anything up, a picture of yourself or anything here in Ballyfermot, there's always good feedback from the people. They all know you because you got so involved in the community, you know.
Thanks.
I want to thank you for that, on behalf of the whole of the heritage here, you know.
It's been a privilege to have worked here for all those years, I must say.
Thanks to Sean again.
Thank you, Sean.
And yourself for taking time out of your day.
Make sure you got my good side, Sean.
I'm talking to Dave O'Rourke, who I used to call Master back in the 60s, and Brother Alton. Dave worked in the school here from 1958 for over 45 years. And Brother Alton started in 1970 here. And we're going to have a chat between the two.
He came here in the summer of 1958. Yeah, at the time, the school was, there were three schools here. Brother Leo, Brother Bonaventure, and Brother Ailby, I think, were the principals. And most of the teachers would have been brothers at the time, and quite a number then of late teachers. Ballyfermot was just still new at the time, and a lot of the people would be telling me that they were sent out the country because they would have originated around Thomas Street, Francis Street, and that area. So a lot of the people that came, and people often said to me, they were calling it Belly Far Out. Yeah. They said they were so far from the city. So principal at the time, they arrived into my class with the cardinal, and he was introducing him, and he was saying, "Is Cardinal Morelli from Rome?" And a hand shot up from one of the lads, and he says, "Cardinal," he says, "you have relations here," he says, in, I think it was Landon Road, the Morellis.
Yeah,
I can see.
And yourself, brother, you came in the 70s.
I came in 76.
76, oh, yeah. 76.
76, I'm only fairly young, you know.
Yeah.
I came in 76, I was in Dundalk for 10 years. I remember starting in Dundalk in 66, and I had 49 in the class, four class, I remember that. And I enjoyed Dundalk, and then I was changed here to Ballyfermot, and of course I knew about Ballyfermot because the majority of the LaSalle brothers in Ireland have been to Ballyfermot, were in the school here, or at least did some studies here, you know. So we all, Ballyfermot was our first big school in Dublin. The first school in Dublin, we were invited in here in 1947 by the Archbishop. School, and so we, the school started in 52, as you know.
Well, thanks, Sean, for the video.
Okay.
And yourself, brother, and yourself, Dave, for taking time out of your day.
Yeah, and I'd like just to say thanks very much, because it was always good to come back to Ballyfermot and the school.
Yes, well, it's been most of my life, because I was my second home, Ballyfermot, in one sense, like, you know.
I want to thank Brother Alton for the stuff that he donated to the Heritage Group. It'll be all on display on Heritage Day in August. And thanks very much for them. Great collection there. You know, we have the drums and the whole lot from the school.
And we got the old key in the school.
And we got the key, and we got
the
trowels and different things like that. Yeah, now we have it all there.
Yeah.
And we got them all shined up, and they're there on display. And please God, they'll be there after we all go, you know.
Well, that's why I handed them over, because we have a place down in Castle, they could have gone down there, but they'll never be seen again.
Yeah.
They belong to Ballyfermot, leave them there, you know.
In March 2019, the last confirmation of the boys took place in Our Lady of the Assumption Church. On the 4th of April 2019, it was a bit of a shock to see they were removing the statue of St. John Baptiste de La Salle, which had stood at the school entrance for so long. Every pupil who attended the school will remember this statue, and I'm sure there are thousands of boys who have had their picture taken on their confirmation day standing beside this statue. We believe it was taken to a monastery in Dundalk. The De La Salle Science Fair was held on the 31st of May 2019, and this gave the boys the opportunity to display their very creative projects.
October, I'm 29 years.
29 years.
Here,
oh
but we're gone before then, so 28 and a half.
28,
I started here in October 1980, straight out of school after me leaving cert, and been here ever since.
My God, oh my.
Remember a couple of years ago, Brother Francis and Brother Kieran were principals, and at the time, and there was new staff had to come in, and they just gelled in with everybody else. And I remember remarking to the two of them, they just had a knack of picking the right people for De La Salle Ballyfermot. They were people that just blended in with everybody else and just were super staff in the school. Yeah. When I started here first, I was down in what's now Brother Eugene's music room. That was my small office. That was my office. And how we ever fit everybody and everything into it is beyond me now. But when I started, there was so little to be done admin wise, and I moved into that office and I had a desk, a telephone, a green metal typewriter and roll books. That was my first job to do when I started working here, and after a couple of days, sure, I had the roll books done. That was grand. After 2 weeks I was bored stiff. I had nothing to do, and I remember going home and saying it to my mummy, God bless her. I said, oh, I don't think I can stick it down there. It's too boring. Because I need to be on the go. And she said, well, look, just stick it for a year. Because I was only out of school after doing the leaving. She said, stick it for a year to get yourself that bit of experience. And then we'll see how it goes. And I said, yeah, I'll stick it for the year then. 28 years later, I never, ever could have imagined working anywhere else.
And it's, have you anything lined up now for that?
No, nothing lined up yet. I'll start looking. As my girls are saying at home, I have to get a job in the real world now. I'll start looking during the summer, please God, I'm sure.
I don't think
God alone only knows where I'll end up. As long as it's not in the gutter, I'll be okay.
Ah, you'll be all right. Well, thanks very much for taking your time now. We are busy.
I know you're busy.
And thanks for all the years.
Thanks for all the help you've been doing here as well. Thanks very much. Yeah. Thanks, John.
Thanks, John. And talking to Linda Corcoran, a lot of people in Ballyfermot would know Linda through our great community work here and also in the school, the De La Salle School here. Linda, you were born in Ballyfermot, were you?
Born and bred in Ballyfermot, yeah. Probably die here too.
God almighty.
no moving on me, yeah.
Yeah. And how many years are you in the school here?
I'm 14 years here.
14 years, yeah. It'll be a sad day on Friday for everyone.
Oh, yeah. A few tears. Well, yeah. I put 3 sons through here. And my daughter was nearly reared here as well as a baby.
And every one of them are doing well,
doing
which is great, you know,
well,
thank God.
Brilliant. Good education they got.
Yeah, I'd say you had many a funny incident here in the school.
Absolutely, yeah, very funny.
Can you give us a couple?
Actually, one of my lads was himself was in trouble with the teacher. He decided to go on strike. So I nearly got the sack over him. But Miss Plant, being Miss Plant, didn't give me the sack. She just let me go for a walk to calm down. I came back in and gave him a week suspension. And Miss Lally gave him a week's homework in maths. He had to turn in every day. So yeah, he remembers it to the day.
Brilliant. Thanks very much, Linda, for that. Thanks very much. That's great.
Thanks for all your hard work. It was great. Thanks very much.
To Keith Walsh, who was the caretaker, and I know Keith, you're more than the caretaker here in the school. Where did you grow up?
I grew up. I'm from Shamrock Davis. That's where I was born and bred.
Yeah.
But I grew up in Ballyfermot.
Yeah.
And I came to the De La Salle school as well.
And how many years? Oh yeah, you went through the De La Salle here.
Yeah, I came to the De La Salle. Yeah.
And how many years are you doing the?
7 years doing caretaking.
7 years.
Yeah.
And I know you're doing more in caretaking. I saw you the other day involved in sport. You're involved in everything really in the school.
Yeah, I love the sports. I love helping the kids out with the sports as well.
I saw that, And I heard the teachers, they're calling you for everything really.
Oh, yeah. You do bits and pieces and everything in the school. Yeah.
Brilliant. And you love the school.
I love what you're doing.
And it must be great meeting all the kids that have grown up now.
And I remember them, you know, and it's great to see them.
I hope you buy you the odd drink and downies or whatever.
I wish.
You're taking some nice memories away, would you?
Brilliant.
What amazes me about the school here is they're all long serving in the school, the staff.
Yeah.
There's no one here just for a short time. Must have all got on great as a family.
It's like a family. And everyone gets on with each other and help each other out.
Brilliant. Well, thanks, Keith, for that.
Thanks, that's great.
And thanks very much. No problem at all.
Thanks very much.
Thank you. All right. I'm talking to Aoife Borland in the yard of the De La Salle here, where 1,500 boys used to play back in the 50s and 60s. Aoife, how many years are you here now?
I started in 2000, so this is my 19th year, or my 20th year, so 19 years I've done here in the De La Salle.
And where are you from originally then?
I'm originally from Terenure. My family's from the north, so Terenure is where I'm originally from myself.
And this is your first posting, was it?
This was my first posting, straight out of college into working in the De La Salle, right to the school. And I was subbing for a few days. Brother Kieran, the principal at the time, said to me, "Would you like a job here, teacher?" And I said, "Oh yeah, of course." I mean, I wasn't going to say no to him. But he said, "Well, that's great, your interview is now." So I had to go in next door and have an interview on the spot. No preparation for it whatsoever. And a week later, I found out the job was mine, so that's how it happened.
So there was great celebrations at home?
Well, great celebrations. I didn't have to go through 20 interviews and that was it.
And I say you have many happy memories here, have you?
Oh, I really do. I really, really do. I mean, it's just very, very sad to be leaving a place where you just know so many fantastic things went on, in my experience, in the De La Salle in the years that I was here.
And it must be great to see the kids now of 19 years ago. I'm sure you see some of them, they come back to the school.
Oh, I do, sure. Over the years, he'd be walking the street and a grown man with a beard and a moustache would be shouting, goes, "Miss, do you remember me?" But and you're like, yeah, I always remember you, yeah. And always, you know, so pleasant when you meet somebody from the school that you taught years ago. There's never really been any bad experiences and everyone would come up and have the chat and say, "Do you remember this? And do you remember this?" And, you know, always, always positive experience chatting to the lads, the past pupils.
Thanks very much for taking the time out. Thanks, Sean, as well. Thank you both very much.
And thanks so much for marking the ending of the school here for us in such lovely ways. And I appreciate that also.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a million.
The final week, we had the pleasure of spending a day in the school with the boys and teachers as they got ready to leave. Well, the day we were all dreading is finally here. The 28th of June, 2019. The day that the doors closed for good after 67 years. And it was great to see so many people dropping in to say thank you to the teachers and past teachers who were all there. It was such a beautiful morning for such a sad day.
Was on the 21st of May, my daughter came of age. And sadly, a happy day, he finally reached the stage. With training on the taxi street, he faced the task ahead. So off he set on his way back to the chance to clear his head. To pick the tea to win the race was not an easy ask. But Steve and Josh and Charles there.
Bring the sun to my room through the door you've opened. Give me a smile I can keep for the while in my heart. once again.